You have my queen.
Hey, listen, pay attention. It's the fucking D12 video. It's the motherfucking intro.
Intro, homie.
The intro, homie. To the motherfucking D12 DVD. Welcome to D12 World. Check it out. What's up, y'all? I'm Eminem. You're about to take a sneak peek into what the recording process is like working with D12 right here. Check it out. The recording process, basically, we keep it moving. Everything is like,
we hear a beat first. You know, we hear the beat, whatever it is, and we just listen to what the beat is saying.
Like if Denon came in here, he would start on something. And when he start on something, whether it's a chorus or a verse or the beat, whatever, we come in here, then we'll add our element to it.
Whoever wants to jump on the track, jumps on the track. You know, it's just like day by day, you know, song by song we take it.
That's how we usually make the track. We listen to the beat first and then we write to it.
But whether if it's two of us in the studio or three of us in the studio, we all know what the D12 vibe is and what our style is.
Basically, we use the same formula that we use on the first album because it worked.
It's not really a complicated process. You know, we all come together as a family.
Dude, I hear that whoa again in the Pro Tools. I'm like, what is that, dude? I'm doing the words and it's going whoa. Whoa, like it's whoa, too slow. Oh, no.
I think as the Pro Tools is trying to keep up, I think it's doing that sound.
Pro Tools is trying to keep me down, dude. That's all it's trying to do. Keep me down. Keep me from proceeding to be the lead singer of the band, dude. And this is what I'm destined to be. And you don't understand it. It's bigger than you. It's bigger than me. It's bigger than everybody. It's the band, dude. The. Meaning me.
Yeah. We are live tonight at 50 Sounds. We're trying to make the band with the band. And all you need is the band to make the band. If you don't have the band to make the band, what kind of band you gonna have to expand without the band that you need to make the band to expand? Now expanding, you gotta have a band. And if you had a band to expand, you gotta make sure you wanna expand with the band. Cause if you don't have the band to expand, you won't expand without the band. And without the band, how you gonna expand? You see what I'm saying, my man?
Hell yeah.
The band. That's all we talking about. To expand, the band.
What's your name again?
Swift.
Swift, and I made the band.
Okay.
I made the band, my man, and it's band.
Okay, this is gonna be a clash of egos, dude. I'm the one with the big head here. I get all the fucking dames, I get all the broads, I get all the chicks, I get the fancy hotel rooms, the big dressing rooms.
What do you think of the D12 video shoot, Andre?
Yo, I think it's dead right.
Hell yeah. This shit is dead right.
Dude, do you want me to play the song you guys wrote or not?
Exactly.
That I take the credit for.
Even the chorus you said.
Yeah.
Everything that I wrote gotta be in that one song.
And in the video, you guys like play the back. I'll be on the camera like, dude, I'm rocking, I'm rocking, bro. Hell yeah, I'm rocking. And you know, I'm rocking the mic and I'm rocking the chicks. I get all the hot buckets, I got a big dick. Hell yeah. Seriously though? Seriously? In all seriousness? I'm being serious now. Okay, this is our hit, okay? I'm gonna be the lead singer, okay?
I'm gonna be the writer of the lead single.
You guys write me the hits, okay. I sing them, make the money, get all the hot chicks.
And hide the contracts.
Oh, dude, I'll do whatever.
Wait.
Is that my phone or yours? I don't know, I'm blowing up, dude.
These chicks don't even know my name on my band. But they're on me like they want to hold hands.
That's why I rock my solo.
What?
Hey. You want to back up singing my band?
I want you to back up what just happened and tell me exactly.
So,
So if you're with it, you can be in my band. If you're not down with it, dude, then you don't get no time in the video.
As long as I don't write a verse about walking 4 hours for cheesecake.
Girl, why can't you see you're the only one for me and it just... Nah, you recorded it wrong. That's not how I said it. Yeah, it's going through the vocals, like it's going through the mic and doing something weird, because this ain't how I'm singing it. Yeah, Pro Tools are fucking up again, yeah.
You know, this is my accomplishment with one man. Got my score with just one man right there. I'm going for that score up there, y'all. I'm coming for you, Vine. I'm almost to 200,000 with one man. Man, don't make no scene, I'll call you. I'll call you.
Oh, what do you got, a pee now? Oh, here he goes. Every 8 hours.
I wish we just had an engineer here and didn't have to go to the bathroom, eat, sleep, or nothing.
So I said to myself, I wish we had an engineer.
I sat back and pondered about previous engineers that I had before that never used the bathroom in his life. I didn't want to tell Mike about this because I knew it would hurt his feelings. But really, I felt deep inside, fuck Mike's feelings. But I didn't want to tell him that. My two-way looked at M dead in his eye. I was feeling the anger and emotional distress from all the years and years of constant bickering. I wanted him to know I wanted out. I just didn't know how to tell him. He looked so happy, cheering, gleeful. He just got finished dropping some vocals. I didn't really like him. But I gave him the thumbs up anyway, as I always do. Because I want job security.
He's the newest member of D12 right here.
B-Boy Stan.
See how he cut? We already groomed him. He already been groomed.
Hey, yo. Now it's recording.
You should check it out.
And I'm sporting a gun like Air Jordan. And this shit's important. So listen. We got Max. We're on a mission. Listen. Anybody trying to be in our position? You know why? We the hardest motherfuckers in the world. Make you want a soccer girl. We the hardest motherfuckers in the world. We make you want a soccer girl.
Yes, I have fun in the booth.
Yeah.
They straighten out. Straighten out.
Shoes, man!
Stop!
Which is which? Who's here? Who? Yeah. Who we help?
Who's on top?
Who we help?
Oh, shit. Oh! Oh,
who's who? Who do we help?
Who do we help?
It's a lot different with this record because we had a lot more creative control as far as what music we was gonna use.
The first album was just Dre, Eminem, and a Karn artist. This album, those three again.
We've used outside producers. You know, we got Kanye West,
Red Spider.
We got Sick Notes from Detroit.
We got the Track Boys from St. Louis.
We work with High Tech, who did the High Tech and Quaalib song that. Snatty.
Can't forget Dre, you know what I'm saying? That's second nature. You already know you want Dre on the track. You know what I'm saying? Because Dre make it happen.
They gave us a different vibe to work from. That's why I think this album is dope, because it's not your typical D12. If you love the first D12 album, we got some of that on there for you. But with the help of these producers, they really brought us to another light, too, so you can see us in other angles.
You'll see him on the camera. You'll see him on the camera.
What the fuck are you doing? Oh my god. Look at this guy.
He's vibing in the room, man.
What the fuck?
You're a camera.
Let me tell all my black people something. Quit worrying about all this bullshit. I'm about to change over. I'm gonna be a straight up skateboard nigga.
Hey, yo,
watch. That's what's finna happen. I think I just found my shit. I found my shit. I will beat your ass, but I'm gonna ride skateboards from now on.
The type of MC that will assault and kill. Wake up in the morning and eat you like Marto meal.
Then once we got the pieces to the track was never laid. So then we had to lay the track. But the tempos weren't matching to the vocals. So then we had to match.
Nah, I won't be mixed down now.
It what?
Won't be mixed down no more.
Oh, okay. Then.
Wait, I think you might have just fixed something.
We're a rubber. You might as well have waited until the whole of the love on court. Sure as hell ain't gonna go to court for my mother or my wife and my sister. So motherfucker mistress.
There you go.
That was me. I say Scooby Dooby Doo.
Oh my god, that shit is crazy. What are you doing?
You got the motherfucker come over with a video camera and everything.
I just want to know why you have your shirt off in the booth. You really think you're sexy, don't you? Like, you are convinced in your head.
I thought what happened was Joe had the heat up too hot.
Yeah, right. He was in the booth feeling himself. Ladies and gentlemen, this is Louis Resto. After 12 hours straight of playing the bass nonstop, this is what it all comes down to. Woo! And Dirty Steve on the guitar. And Slick Black Jesus.
Hey, what
you hard as hell.
I'm hard as hell.
You hard as hell. Now I'm the hardest motherfucker in the world.
Good looking out. Now hard as hell.
He the hardest motherfucker in the world, number two.
He the hardest motherfucker in the world.
Number one. No, matter of fact, I'm the hardest motherfucker in the world, number one A. And he the hardest motherfucker in the world, number one B.
Right.
We both the hardest motherfuckers in the world, number one.
Two is in also. Now, two is in number two. Like, you the hardest motherfucker, too.
Exactly.
There can't be two hardest motherfuckers in the room at the same time.
In the same room.
In the same room.
Same camera.
Ha! Guns! Ha! Ha! It doesn't matter, cause I'm hard as you. I leave you in particles. They'll be reading you in the article.
Obituaries. Yeah, it's kinda scary. The way that I roll, you swear I'm military. I lay on your back like Mariah Carey. Lay your ass down, down to the ground. Fuck you in your ass, then turn you around. Well, not really. That's just what I did to her. Hey, yo, Swifty, get on the mic and stir.
I took a fur from a bitch. Chinchilla. Cause I'm just that type of nigga. Swifty McVay. That's my name. Blasting you with my motherfucking thing. The hardest motherfucker in the world. We make you wanna sock your girl. We the hardest motherfuckers in the world. We make you wanna sock your girl. We got another verse.
Rockin' home every night. Rockin' home night.
Going the alternative route now, you know, the hardest motherfucking rockers in the world.
I'm just ready to rock and roll, man. That's what I'm here for, man. That's it.
This is the lead singer of Narrow Smith.
It's me. My name's Tommy Lee Smith.
Smith. Put it 40 out! Put it 40 out! Put it 40 out! Put it 40 out! What? Put it 40 out!
Put it 40 out! Put it 40 out!
One take, one.
Y'all wanna hear the D12 album or Color Me Bad's new album?
Color Me Bad.
Bad.
I heard they got I Wanna Set You Up Part 8 on there. I'm telling you, Roger.
Favorite song? That's a good question.
My favorite song right now was Get My Gun. And why? Because I like going to get my gun. I really like that song. Got all the members on there. It's up tempo, it's fast, it's raunchy, it's amped. You know what I'm saying? I like it. You know what I'm saying? Just, I'm going to get my gun. That's, it just fits me.
Let's Get It Cracking, because I like the energy that it has on it. And the beat is just so crazy. It's like, it's something you never, ever heard before.
It's a song called Good Die Young, and it's talking about, well, my verse, basically, we're just talking about people who like die young and, you know, struggles people go through. And we're talking about Bugs. You know, he was the member in D12 who got killed right before we came out with the album.
I think, I'm gonna tell you, my favorite song, I don't have a favorite song. It's too many songs. I got a lot of favorite songs.
If I had to pick a favorite track off the album, it would have to be every one that I'm on.
Skip. You already put that other one back in?
Skip.
That other high one?
Did I say? It was all like, hey, Mike. I want you to put the other high one in. Where's the other high one? Hello? Where's your brain, dude? Where's your brain particles? Can you muster up some? Huh? What the hell?
Cause we don't like guns, we bored of them.
Some of that, fuck
with them. It's what I have, and I spit at you, some and I laugh at your lyrical style, because it's not lyrical at all. As a matter of fact, you're very small. You're not tall at all.
Some of that, fucking with the samurai, and they wonder why I laugh at you, because I got a sorcerer's lyrical style about you. Did you hear the funniness? You're a dummy, because it's just crazy how I come with the lyrical lazy style.
Sometimes I'll be laid back on the beat, so laid back that the track will go ahead of me and flow. It'll be like I'm floating on a cloud. But sometimes I get quiet, then I get loud. Then I go up, then I go down.
Down.
I go in, then I go out.
Out.
I go at the back, and I go in the front, and I'm in the backyard. I'm in the front yard. You don't even know where I am, because you front hard. You are not an MC. I am the MC in the place to be. You don't understand me. Me. I. Me, not you.
Oh. We have power every hour with the power MCs in the car, which we'll be trying to stop.
Even in the shower, we'll take you out with the power. You cannot see our. That means us together.
Huge, oversized, extremely enormous, gigantic, humongous foot fungus baby.
Big baby! Big baby!
Is it cold or hot now?
It's none of your business. What's your name again?
The janitor.
Oh, the janitor that sometimes plays keyboards.
That's me.
Oh, hey. Look at me. I want a keyboard solo. Yeah, well, you're going to have to buy it. You have to steal it over my body. No, dude. I'm going to do everything. I'll be like, go back on the tape, Honey Mac. You see me jamming on the guitar, bro? Yeah, dude. Yeah, it's me. Dude, that's me. Oh, you want to get me on the keys, too? So I got preview and preview of it. What's that, dude? I'm not playing that.
Yeah,
I'm not
we're definitely playing that.
That's not coming from my lively fingers, dude.
Try it again.
Listen. There's a slight delay on it, but please excuse me, ladies and gentlemen.
Came back in here and sat down. That's when I noticed a set of 30-pound weights sitting here. I thought to myself, this had to be M's work. Only he walks around with weights. Half the time I think, why does he lift these kind of things? And I never see any kind of improvement in his figure. But every time I see him, I call him Cock Diesel for his own self-esteem. Sit back and just thought quietly to myself.
There you go.
Something. You gonna get somebody car today?
Cause you know where I'm from.
Yeah.
Yo, Jim, dog.
I'll be like this.
That ain't even my
blunt.
My blunt ain't got nothing on that.
Hey, whoa, don't kill my artist. God damn, nigga.
Never forget you. Damn. That was awesome. Be real. I'm saying,
please, can't. Let me tell you,
whatever, man. I do what the fuck I want to, because I'm a G.
Let's add some floats, too.
Okay, let's go. Come on, dude. Wait, what's taking you so long? You're wasting studio hours. Millions of fans to be pleased right now. And you're wasting that precious time listening to me rant and ramble on about nothing at all.
Damn!
I think myself as an artist and as a producer and Danon, you know, as far as production and everything, like, we've all come together and we've gotten better at it and we've all grown.
Really learning from doing this album and being around M all these years, that you can't just be a one-dimensional MC. You gotta learn how to, you know, just do everything. You might have a pimp beat, and then on the next song you might have like a hardcore beat, and the next song might have a love song. You can't just go around just killing people all day. You know what I'm saying? Sometimes you gotta just sit down and sleep. You can't kill people all day. You gotta smile, man.
I think everybody surprised me. You know what I'm saying? I think everybody stepped it up 100%.
So that's what I feel like I learned. Like, I gotta stay more focused because, you know, I enjoy the fans. I love that the fans represent us and everything, and I got love for them, because if it wasn't for them, we wouldn't be here.
I have to say that the group, I think, actually learned how. I seen them step up to the plate with a lot of songs. I think they, you know, the first album, nobody really knew what they had inside of them. And we all was growing.
I think everybody learned patience and found comfort.
And so that made the process flow real, real smooth. And it took a lot of pressure off Marshall, because you remember, he just finished doing the Obie Trice album. He just finished doing Tupac's album.
We're gonna bring more of our identity to the picture. We're gonna let you guys know how we feel individually in ourselves.
If we are already a collective as a group this time, you get to hear everybody's separate ideas. You can tell what everybody's input is. And it's not so much, hey, Eminem, the Eminem shadow.
It's a learning the whole recording process is a learning process, you know, because every day you learn something new about making tracks. Every day, you know, I make it better, or Danon make it better at making tracks. The more, the better the tracks get, the better the raps get, the better, you know, and vice versa. But, you know, we just keep it moving.
It was fun. Felt like old, like the old days when we used to be in the studio.
You just try to make it a D12 world, man.
I don't think anybody is gonna expect the album to be this crazy.
So everybody, whole game is up. This is an incredible album, I'm telling you. It's out the door. I love it.
Welcome to D12 World, bitch.
You only got the flat side and the black side. Pick which one you want, bitch. Been doing, been getting, baby, been shining, baby. Ain't nothing, been smacking you, bitch, for my fault.
Hey,